Red Fox, recording the music for these four segments of MASH. And in one of the titles, he wrote something in the ledger lines on the bass clef, which has always been somewhat of my weakness in reading ledger line notes. And I had rehearsals with Benny about it, and so I had problems with it, but I told him not to worry about it because the blah, blah, blah. Also, too, when this happened, I had only been here maybe 2 years, and a lot of my New York character and personality and attitude was still with me. And I forget that I'm in another environment. Anyway, back in those days, tape, red light, film, a band, a orchestra. And when you run the, once you start the film, the red light goes on. If there's a mistake, well, number one, you rehearse the music before you actually record it to make sure that it's been copied right. So during the rehearsal, we get to this one segment, this one title, and we're playing, and they get to this part that bothers me. And I sort of kind of flub it in a way. And Benny says, Chuck, you know, I say, Benny, don't worry about it, it's okay. Blah, blah, blah. It's the first time that I worked with Tommy. And of course, we have said hello, how you doing, and blah, 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 and all that. But that's the first time I'm with him. So we go through this particular thing. So the red light goes on. I know that if there's a mistake made, they got to stop the film, and they got to stop the recording and go back, because we're still in tape in those days. So we start recording, and we get to this part, and I make a mistake. I flub it. I'm going, damn it. Tommy goes, now I knew who he was. I heard a whole lot about it. He went over his guitar, he went, I said, oh man. No. So that's cool. I said, wow, I'm glad that somebody else made a mistake rather than me. Run it back. Oh, and they say, Tommy, you all right? Tommy said, and he was Tommy Tedesco. So I said, somebody else had a problem with this. Run the tape back, start it again. We get to the same place, and I make a mistake again on this particular part. And Tommy goes, and so producer says, Tommy, all right? He says, it's okay. So I'm going, and he turns to me and he says, that's the last time. And I realized that he's doing me a favor. He's hearing me mess it up. And he did this twice and put it on him. So the third time we go back to play this, when we get to that part, it's only like a one bar, two bar phrase. I just don't play. Now I'm scared to death. I just don't play. I just let it go by. So we finish the track. And of course, before they excuse the orchestra, they check the music with the film. And so once we're finished, I'm sitting there like this, and Tommy, he's sitting right next to me. He goes, he touches me like this, and he says, oh, so well, obviously that means that if you can't do it, don't do it. Oh, well, he went like this. I said, shh. We listened to him. When they played it back, Denny, I heard the bass. I didn't play it, but I heard the part. I heard the part. And so I'm sitting there going, and Benny's looking at me going, you know, because he knew that I had trouble with it, and now I got it straight, and blah, blah, blah. And after we finished, Tedesco went. So I thought he meant that if you don't know, if you're not going to do it, don't do it at all. And so on the break, we go to the break room, and he says, man, I'm Tedesco, Tom Tedesco. He says, you know, it's great to work with you. I heard a lot about you and the blah, blah. The contractor said that you want to be on the date, the blah, blah, blah. He looked at me, and he said, every bass clef instrument in this orchestra has that part. Every last one of them. So the first time that you missed it, the second time around, it's up to you to decide if you want to play it. Did your ego want to play it? He said, you didn't even have to play it. As it is, we heard the bass. And that way, we didn't have tracks. There was, at the most, it could have been eight tracks or four with the rhythm section. There's no way he's going to know that you didn't play it. You know, and he says, don't get scared. He says, fear does that. And I said, thank them and blah, blah, blah. Thanks for saving me. He said, no problem at all, man. No problem at all. You know, you're a good player. You're here for a reason. Because it's a first call band. You know, you're here for a reason. He says, just don't be afraid of this shit. You know, and I remember I got in my car going back home. I said, what a nice gesture from a real nice guy to do that for me. You know, because I've seen other people really come down hard on other musicians, especially if they were new. But it's just so kind, the way he went. I didn't even look at me. So I tell that story with a lot of love.